end up here, he's going to come back. So the minister's going to come back to whakaroa the house. And then when we come back again, when we come back on Thursday, he's then going to do another one for us when we come back here. Okay, but what he's done is that he's going to come back later on today to do that, and then we'll come back again on Thursday when we leave Te Huruhi. So, Matua, if we can, please, just to sort of bless our journey from here now to Manukau Memorial Gardens, and then the journey for us heading up home. That's all, just a karakia, so o tēnei we whakanō the house. Yeah. So I'll shoot up there as well, because what we're going to do is I had a kōrero with Joe last night, and we're going to get the Kiwi boys to take him from here into the chapel,
yeah.
And then we'll get the Kiwi boys, another six or whoever, to put him back into this waka.
Yeah.
And then we'll shoot off. Yeah? Ka pai?
Okay,
so Manny, you alright?
Yeah.
So don't blame me if I get you first. Not that there's a race. Okay then,
but
do you
want to come with him and I can book her? So when we get there, we'll get all the flowers and that off and the photos and set them up first.
Okay.
Just before they take them.
Thank you.
didn't know today would be your last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, well, God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah. My desire.
nothing else can take your place. Oh no, no, to feel the warmth of your heart, we give you our minds, we give you our body and soul, all that we have, we give to you. Let this be your prayer, your heart's desire, and after all, he owns it all.
his side. Can't remember a day when you weren't around. You were always there. I still hear your voice in my head. See you laughing, see you smiling in my mind. If I had the chance again, I would tell you that I love you one last time. Yet I still can't believe that you're gone, that you're gone. Oh, we cry, we cry.
So many friends you left behind, so far away. And once you reach the heaven high, as the jury remains inside.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Follow behind and they will set him up when we're inside.
So look, we've just got our matua here. Our matua is one of the kaumatua at OC, Otahuhu College, the best college in whole of the Aotearoa. And so yeah, our kaumatua just let you know what's going to happen, and also just the karakia, and the boys will do the school haka as he walks in. Hey, you. As he walks in, and also do the haka as he comes out. So I said to Lindsay and his crew who's carrying him in, if you fellas want to use the trolley, it's okay. It's okay. You know, so they're going to have a look at it, because I explained to them that the brothers used the trolley yesterday and pushed them in. But it's up to you fellas. So I don't have my...
Yeah. Kia ora, talofa lava, malo lelelo, whakalofa la hiatu. Greetings. Thank you for gathering for day 19. Olsen's had the longest hikoi, and I think it's taken a while to gather people together and gather his stories together and gather everything together to make the farewell and the last journey back to home, the right time. Thank you for being part of this ongoing journey. And so on behalf of the family, others will speak specifically, but they appreciate your support. I acknowledge those who are gathering with us in Australia. One of the joys of live streaming, of course, is that don't think we're the only ones. And in the past, when we didn't have live streaming, we had to believe in the spirit world. Now we know that other people are watching and joining us. So we think of you in Australia, the whānau there. We acknowledge you letting him be part of our journey too. Today's service is primarily a simple one. But it is the last one when we gather here in Māngere. So it takes on a special significance as we send him forth this afternoon. But it's still a simple service. It's still one full of humility and aroha and spirit. God is with us. God's love unites us. God's purpose steadies us. And God's Spirit comforts us. Blessed be God forever. Amen. I invite you to stand and we'll sing the hymn Whakaria Mai, which is on your sheet. Unfortunately, we have to sing through masks, sort of. But just keep yourself safe, and if you don't want to sing, hum the words or think the words. Please stand. Alf's going to lead us.
Thank you.
Please sit. A reading from Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes into the hills, but where shall I look for help? My help comes from the Lord, who has made heaven and earth. The Lord will not let your foot stumble. The one who guards you will not sleep. The one who keeps watch over this people shall neither doze nor sleep. The Lord is the one who will guard you, for the Lord is on your right hand, and he will be your defense, so that the sun shall not strike you by the day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. Yes, it is the Lord who will keep you safe. The Lord shall take care of your coming in and your going out, from this time forth and forever. Amen. Thank you as we gather from Sydney, from Samoa, from Hawaii, from around the country. Thank you as we gather as families, as friends, as players. Thank you as we gather in this place and we acknowledge Tainui and we ask that Napui is ready for him, because they will be. They are waiting. We acknowledge his mum and his brother and those who are already waiting to welcome him. We acknowledge the other greats. We remember Joelle and Inga, who I'm not sure if Olsen's guiding them or they're guiding Olsen. But what a formidable three, and what a great loss. Today's story is not told by me. For those who don't know me, my name's Peter Sykes. I've worked with Alf for about 30 years on the streets of Mangere, with the Mangere East Hawks. And it's my privilege to be able to wrap around and support the whānau with this process today. We're going to, I've got a sort of who's who, and I'm assuming that Alf has warned you that you're one of the who's who. But after the time of people who I will specifically invite up, it is open for anyone else who would like to come forward and say some words, or just come up and acknowledge Olsen. Sometimes words are not needed. But the whānau, they appreciate your presence with them. At the end of the speaking, Alf's going to tell us what we did wrong, and he's going to sum it all up, or do a bit of storytelling, and then we've got a little video, and then we're going to do a after Alf's spoken, we're going to have a waiata. So if you're a speaker, you do not need to waiata. You can if you want to, but you don't need to. After Alf's and the waiata, we've got a short video clip of Olsen. It turned up by magic yesterday, right at the end of the tangi. And so we've got just to remind us the man on the field. After that, we'll have our closing karakia, and then we'll send Olsen forward. Don't expect people to sort of remember too far advanced. So when we get to that point of time, I'll tell you what the next steps are. But it's my privilege to invite Olsen's older brother, Joe, to come forward to talk to us.
Good afternoon, friends and players that knows Olsen through the years. There's some familiar faces that I've seen. Te ara ni kau. It's awesome to have to be here to celebrate, not celebrate, but to honour Olsen as we take him back home, Awarua, Kaikoi. I'd like to acknowledge the phone call that we received yesterday. Alfred had a phone call from Michael Jones, and Michael Jones sent his love and condolences to the family, wishing you a well and safe journey back home to be with Mum. Sorry, my brother Olsen can't make it because unforeseen circumstances, but my love and heartfelt blessings go out to you and bless and family. So God bless you, brother Ollie Michael Jones. This is, when Alfred got that phone call, he put me on the spot and he says, "Hey, yeah, bro, here, Michael Jones." "What? Oh, no, I don't want to talk to him." "No, I don't want to talk to him." He said, yeah, just acknowledge his sympathy, you know. Okay. So what I said, "Malo, whakatai lava." That's all. And I said, and then I gave it back to Alfred and I said, "Thank you, Jones, Michael, for the heartfelt sympathy that you've given our family." So it's only too right that I answer and acknowledge that. And through you, Michael, I'd like to bless you and your family. And God bless you. So unforeseen circumstances could be many things. But I gave the phone back to Alf. So as I was listening, he's going like this, "Uso!" And I was saying, "What? What's uso?" You know, I thought this was a cocktail mix, uso, lemonade, and raspberry. And I said, "Alf, what's uso?" He says, "Brother." Didn't even know. Even though I'm Samoan, but Father never taught us the Samoan language. Yeah, so all that said, I'd like to introduce myself and my family, my brothers. I am the oldest. My name is Joseph Douglas Filipaina. Then I have my brother Olsen on my left, Olsen Orakewa Filipaina. And then Alfred Meredith Filipaina. A flash name, my brother, very flash. Then we have the other brother. Oh my God. We have another brother that's over in Oz. He's there. He did all the work over there just to sort of help us out to bring him back here for his final rest. So, thanks to my brother Jerry Cassidy Filipaina. And then we have Philip Filipaina Filipaina. And then the young brother, Ray, Alan Filipaina. He's buried with Mum. He's the baby. He laid him on top of Mum to rest. And Ollie wanted to get buried on top of the brother. So I'm glad he's back here. We almost, we had a bit of bit of a stripe there, but stripe with the olive bringing him back. We actually thought he's going to stay there and they would have taken over. But no, the family had decided, no, Ollie, you're going to come back home. So that's what we did. So, he's got a lot of memories. You know, you fellas, I'm sorry, you know the lead players who followed Ollie during his game, you know what he was like. He was a humble man. And he's, you know, if you follow him, he's a really decisive runner. You wouldn't know what he's going to do. But I tell you what, if you follow him and he's got that ball, he'll lay that ball up for you. He's not one of these bullet pass shots that, you know, whoosh. No, he'll see you. He knows you're there. But he'll turn and he'll offload that ball. You know, looking at him, it's like watching him in poetry in motion. His decisive run. His thigh bursts. The things he does with the ball, it's amazing. And he's made a name for himself and made a name for our family. And I'm proud of him. So you Lee guys out there, you know, if you got sons and whatnot, yeah, I encourage you, like, I had a son that was in Manghis, but he passed on. He could have gone a long way. His name was Olsen Filipaina too. He was coached by Ross McEwen and Alan Popata. He made it into the 10th grade for the Auckland team. He was coached by a lady named Yvonne. Sorry, I don't know his second name, but yeah. Gary Kimball, I see you there. Lindsay Proctor, all fellas. Yeah. Sorry, Lindsay. Benny, you know Nelson for 30 years, 30 odd years. Good to see you. Come all the way from Rotorua in your fine white. Welcome. So we're all here to sort of send them off on a happy journey back home. And I appreciate all you folks that are tuned. God bless you all, man. Thank you.
Our next speaker speaks on behalf of the younger generation, Anthony.
Hello everybody. To those who don't know me, I'm Anthony, Alfred's boy, and my mum is just behind, pretty much in line with me, Kath. And like it's been said, I'm speaking on behalf of the nieces and nephews of Uncle Olsen. Some in Australia, just a quick wave and a shout out to them. Some here with us today, and some isolating because of COVID and whatnot. But I also spoke yesterday, and just continuing on from yesterday, it's been a heck of a long week, but the day is finally here where we can finally put Uncle at peace and we can start our journey up north to the path to glory. In the same breath that I say it's been a long week, it's also been a privileged week as a member of this family. For me personally, as a nephew of Uncle Olsen. Privileged in the sense that It's allowed me to spend time with people who have shared the footy field with him, either as a teammate or as an opposition. The stories that people have been telling have honestly been an honour to listen to. A lot of the stories, with even though the details differ, one thing rang true through each and everyone's stories, and that was Uncle's humility. It was highlighted in almost every single speech that we've all had the privilege of listening to. He was so humble, in fact, that like I had never heard any of these stories before. It's because he was so humble. He never sort of sat me down, sat me on his lap, and spread those wise tales of back in the day. Sort of like, oh, back in my day, Neff, I ran 110 meters, scored a try, bumped off 5 people, or how he was 17 playing topside against adults, fully grown men. Never really had that experience where he'd say that himself, because just, as I say again, that humility rang true. But actually hearing it from the people who either got to witness it firsthand or were victims of his wrath, I guess, that sort of highlighted the fact that they were like true stories, and it was honestly amazing to hear the type of person he was on and off the field, and that I'm sure I can speak on behalf of the cousins where I say we're just frequently in awe of the man he was on the footy field, which we didn't really get to experience, but off the field as well, which we obviously did get to experience. I just want to digress for a little bit, just to bring up how I came in possession of this jersey. I was with Mum and Tipu, her partner, who's sitting next to her. We were having a few beers at home with a family friend from Australia, diehard West Tigers fan. Owned this since he was a kid. Kept it in perfect nick. And the second he found out that me and Mum were Filipinas, he didn't hesitate. He took it. He literally took it off his back, gave it to me and Mum, and said that it would be an honour if we could have it. The fact that he's giving his jersey to a Filipina, just it didn't make him hesitate to give the jersey to us, and that highlights the man he was, even to people who had never met him before, who know him, who just know what he's done on the field. So on behalf of all the nieces and nephews, thanks to all those who have shared memories with us, but also thanks in advance to the people who will be speaking after me today. I honestly can't wait to hear more and more of your stories, because I tell you what, I'll never get sick of them. You'll be missed, Uncle. And we will forever hold you in our hearts and in our heads forever. Thank you.
Our next speaker is Namaru. Okay. Filipaina. It's all yours, Phil. You come up with that.
Nah, she's your speaker. She's your tukutuku. Kia ora te lofa, and to my nieces and nephews and their bro and Oz, g'day mate. Like PT, my name is Filipaina. I'm the second youngest. People say they probably ran out of names, that's why they called me the first and second. So I was actually just everybody's just having a lot of memories of the bro, and I was sitting at home with my daughter, Jamie, and she asked who was the most athletic of the six brothers. I mean, there was no choice, it was me, but Olsen did all right too. But I think we're going to get a call from Butterbean soon. Also, I'd like to acknowledge, this one didn't want to stay in the chair. Just acknowledge everybody for coming. Like Pete said, the hiko has been very long for the brew. I think a lot of us need the hiko, just to lose a bit of weight. But anyway, thank you very much, and to all the nieces and nephews in Oz, and bro, our love is always here for the bro. That will never go away. And all my family, I love you all. And my nephew Quinn, who had his speech memorial in Australia for his dad, alluded to the fact that the family tree had a few branches unclear. And our dad was the same. With his family tree, he had a few branches that are unclear. So I'd like to acknowledge my stepsister. I don't like to use the word step, but I'd like to acknowledge my brothers and sisters. They've been a big part of this journey too, and a big part of Olsen's life. So I'd like to acknowledge them. I lost count. I think Dad had another 10. I can't remember. So I said to Jamie, which is going on, I said, babe, when you get older, don't date any Māori or Samoan, they might be related. So thank you very much, and God bless. Thank you.
It's tempting at this point of a service to say, are there any long-lost brothers or sisters who want to speak? I think that's part of the story of Māngere and Māori. I know my own family, we've gone through trauma as peoples, and that's part of the... We laugh about it, but there's also sadness and pain in that journey. So we do acknowledge those connections in that whakapapa. Part of the whakapapa today that Leslie Vainakolo, when he spoke at the Māngere East League the other day, was that Olsen always knew where he came from. He always knew where his land was and his people. And that's why he kept on coming back. He's still coming back and waking Alf up every morning. Probably will wake a few others up over the time. But whakapapa is more than how we relate to each other. It is about how we relate to the land, because it is what grows out of the land. It's why he was able to call the guys that he played with at the Hawks and the Tigers and at Kaikohe and North Sydney and Samoa, Auckland, and New Zealand for the Kiwis, brothers. And so we've got a number here who are going to speak. And then there's an open floor. Can I just really reiterate or say again and again, I guess what Anthony said is that Olsen was a humble man. He didn't speak about his exploits. And so the family would like to hear the stories of what he meant for you. Yesterday we talked about him being the guiding star that opened the pathways for people to travel. And so first up, we're going to ask Tawera to come and speak on behalf of New Zealand Rugby League. Kia ora tau.
Ke matara, ti hei, mauroro, te metu e tai ke te atua, he honore e korori e mangaro ke te whenua whakaaro pai ki ngā tangata kato. A mi atu ki a koutou, e te kigi o potatau te whereawhere o te tūwhitu, te mokapuru in tamariki, te whare, te kaurike, rire, rire, hau, pai mā rire. Mi atu ki a koutou, e te manu whenua, te wako o tainui, o te whānau, o ngā hau e whānau reira koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, a tēnā tātou kato. A mi atu ki a koutou e te matua, e te kura o Otahu, e te timatanga, e te karakia, nā te haka, a kanu te mihi, kanu te aroa. Ki a koutou. A mi atu ki a koutou e te whānau pani, au, o te whānau, oh, Meredith, I mean Meredith. kia ora tātou, nō reira. It's a privilege and honour to be here today to speak on behalf of New Zealand Rugby League. I've got a few apologies, one in particular from the President of the New Zealand Rugby League, Howie Tamariki. Howie, he sends his condolences to you, Alf, in the whānau pani here today. Howie's not in a very good way at the moment, in a bit māwiwi, so he does send his apologies. On behalf of the New Zealand Rugby League Board, Hugh Martin, the Chairman, plus the CEO, Greg Peters, and members of the staff, our condolences are passed on to you, Alfred, and your whānau here today. Just really want to acknowledge you and thank you for the opportunity to say a few words today. And you would have heard all those stories, and they've been regaled over the last 19 days, more so or less, in terms of Ollie and the path that he blazed for all of us. And a lot of the stories, he's very humble. He's probably the humblest Samoan I've ever known. Not like my mate Tiro Party over there, who's sitting in the back row. Every time we used to play against each other, he used to tell me, "I'm going to get you, mate. I'm the best. You'll never see anything like this." Hey, Tiro was like that all the time, but Ollie was one of those blokes that was, you couldn't get boo out of him over the years. And a few days ago, or actually just after the news came through that Ollie had passed, I received a book in the mail, and it was Ollie's book. That he'd signed, and he'd sent me a copy from Australia. And in that book, in the front cover, he'd signed the book, and it said, "Taura, it made me proud to watch you play for the Kiwis," signed by Olsen. So, it's sort of probably coming here today is to really share and pass our condolences and the love that we have at New Zealand Rugby League. You talk about the brotherhood, the camaraderie, bit like your whānaus, and Paul Olsen, he's probably, touched by two cloths here, being half Samoan and half Māori. That's probably the worst mix you can ever have, eh, in terms of that. Loving the kai and the food and everything else. And, Alf used to tell us he was the best player, Joe, but now that I know that you were the best that ever played football, Meredith kept on, I've just stuck in my head now, Meredith, Alf, in terms of that, I'm going to call you Meredith, Councillor Meredith. And they're going, "Who the hell is that?" But it's Alf. But, in terms of that, we had a bit of a gathering at Dane O'Hara's place on Sunday. We have these usually Kiwi catch-ups, and there was lots of stories being told about Olsen and the humbleness and just what a champion player. And from a young age growing up, I was one of those young fellas that used to come to Carlow Park and watch the games on a Sunday, jump over the bank fence and run down and get them for free at Carlow Park back in the day. We never used to pay going to Carlow Park. Everyone else used to get charged, but we never did. And, watching Olsen play in those days, playing for the Kiwis. And I remember, played a lot of rugby league, but I remember I was talking to Wally Lewis one time, and he told me the story about when Olsen actually killed him in that series, and I'm sure Lo will talk about that a little bit later on. But it was just one of those, he said he'd never known what hit him, because Olsen talked about his skills in offloading the ball, but he was also a good defender too in terms of that, Joe. So, those skills, that humbleness, and as you guys have said and you've heard those stories over the last couple of days, just blazed a trail, that one of those trailblazers for the many Polynesians that have gone to the NRL, to rugby union. He was sort of a trailblazer in those late 70s, early 80s, one of the first to go over there and do that. So, you know, for all us Māori, all us Polynesians that have gone on to play rugby league, he definitely was, you know, the trailblazer in terms of getting to Australia. So, you know, as your nephews have said, you're probably going to hear some more stories, and, you know, there'll be a couple of stories. Lindsay Proctor's got to tell a few stories. I don't know if they're X-rated, Lindsay, some of those stories of yours, but we'll try and keep it clean because there's children here today. But just in terms of talking about that, Olsen, you know, was one of the idols. When I was growing up, there was probably two or three players that I really idolised. Mark Graham, Hugh McGann, and Olsen Filipaina. Those were the three players that I really looked up to in terms of that, because they were playing in the NRL, you know, over there in Australia. And I just wanted to be like them, you know, be like those players. So, you know, to Olsen, to his whānau, to you, Alf, it's a real privilege and honour to be here to on behalf of New Zealand Rugby League, on behalf of the Kiwi brothers here, just to offer our condolences to everybody. And as you said, he was a very, very humble man. But so New Zealand Rugby League, we've Kohard commissioned a jumper. This jumper, no one's... It'll be the new Kiwis jumper that possibly will go to the World Cup this year. One of the jumpers that we're looking at doing it. This is, and there's one going to be commissioned, which will be specifically for Olsen. But this is a koha and a gift that we would like for to lay with him. But later on in the year, there'll be another jumper that they'll specially commission.
Just
a bit tight for you there, Meredith, but should be all right for one of your morphin. We'd love this to be buried with Olsen and put in the ground with him in terms of that. And, you know, just on behalf of myself, on behalf of New Zealand Rugby League, the board, you know, all the staff here today, once again, to the whānau pani, just offer our condolences, our love and our support for truly a Pacific pioneer. You know, we talk about Kupe coming to New Zealand, discovering, well, you know, Olsen is in that realm of, you know, discovering Australia for all the Polynesians that went to follow. I just also want to acknowledge, you know, the passing of Inga and also Joelle, to all our whānau out there, all our Pacific peoples. You know, I think there's a bit of a message in that also, in terms of, you know, looking after ourselves, to all our whānau. And Butterbean, you'll probably be giving you a call, Filipaina, definitely. Oh, Dave Latelli, I think he's, you know, should be up there with New Zealand over the years, done some fantastic thing for our people in there. You know, maybe all of us need to go and see Butterbean, not just you fellas, us two. But just in closing, once again, just want to have this, and we have a koha for New Zealand Rugby League too, and this jersey. I'd love to put that up there for and leave it on the casket for you fellas off. So, kia ora.
Well, I won't put on any other jersey, I'll don't want to fuck a mother, put it there right at the front, the top of the keys. Just Ollie, have a good journey, mate.
And it is traditional for us to sing a bit of a waiata, so I'll do the traditional thing for myself, just to make sure we're done. And if you know the waiata, join in and sing it with me. It's called Ko Tēnei Te Wā. Ko Tēnei Te Wā, Ko Waiata Hau, Ka Waiata Kia Iho. Ko tēnei te wā, ka inoi ahau, ka inoi ki te ariki. Waiata aroha nui, waiata aroha nui, waiata haere atu e te rangatira, haere atu ki te kāinga, haere atu ki te rerenga wairua, haere atu e te Hawaiki Nui, Hawaiki Roa, Hawaiki Pāmāmāo, nō reira koutou, ka haere, ka haere, ka haere, kia ora tātou.
Did you want to acknowledge that? Normally we would acknowledge a gift like that, but the family, Alf will do that at the end to pull it all together. unless he wants to do it now, but we don't need to give Meredith all... we don't want to give him too much airtime. It's elections coming up soon. thank you, Tawera. It's humbling. Loi, you are the next on the spot.
Gee whiz, firstly, Alfred or Meredith, thank you. and your whānau, thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to say a few words. You know, from my position, I knew Olsen was my friend, obviously, but I was his coach for a little while, and I had the privilege to do that. And when I look back on my career, you think, gee whiz, you were just a little boy from Otahu. And all of a sudden you were coaching the Kiwis, and how did that happen? And it happened because of men like Olsen. And a little, there's a lot of things I'd like to tell you about him, but we haven't got time. But one thing that very few people knew about, and I've only ever shared it with, I think Mark Graham might be the only one I've told about it. The first year I coached the Kiwis was 1983, and I was just so proud, but I also was a bit scared. Because I was an Otahu player, and I tried, while I was coaching Otahu, I tried very hard to get Olsen to come along and play for us, but we couldn't match what the Mad Butcher was coming up with all the time, so it was a bit difficult. But I was a little bit in awe of this position that I had as coach of the Kiwis. And one of the first things I wanted to do was go over to Australia and see some of the players that were playing for the various clubs over there and make sure it was okay with their clubs and the players, and everybody was all sweet, you know, when it came to selection time. And the first players that I saw were Bruce Gould and Olsen at Balmain. And I remember I met with the two players and also with Frank Stanton, who was Olsen's coach. And we had a bit of a chat at the Balmain Leagues Club there, and Frank might have had a little bit too much to drink. I thought he was disrespectful to Olsen, and I told him so. And so we didn't get off to a good start, I suppose. But anyhow, later on, so we left the meeting, and I was in Sydney for two more days. And I got a call in my, this is before mobile phones, I think, but I got a call just in my room, and it was from Olsen, and he said, could I meet him for a cup of tea? And Olsen, you know, he wasn't that sort of man, was he? He didn't meet people for cups of tea or cups of coffee. He didn't do that. And so I said, yeah, sure. And I arranged to meet him at this little cafe next to Balmain, next to the Leagues Club there. I went down and I'm thinking, oh, what's this? I thought he was going to say that he didn't want to play, or, you know, or whatever. But he said to me, we start to have a cup of tea, and he said, Loi, I don't want you to be scared. And I said, scared what? He said, I don't want you to be scared to be the coach. And I said, I'm not. What are you? And he said, I heard it in your voice. He said, when you were talking to me yesterday, I could tell you were scared. And he said, I don't want you to be, because the players will want to play for you. And he said, I don't want you ever to be scared again, because the players will want to play for you. I mean, that's there's a little part of me. I'm not ashamed, but there's a little part of me that says I shouldn't tell you this sort of thing. But that's how. That Olsen saw in my heart how I really was. I mean, I was so proud. I was just so proud. It was fantastic. But he also saw in me a fear that no one else, many others might have seen, I'm not sure. But Olsen was the one who saw it and said it to me, don't be scared, the players will want to do it for you. It was interesting that the name Filipaina in my life, it actually started with Meredith. Because I coached the under-17s, wasn't it? Under-17s, yes. So Meredith told me how good he was and whatnot, and he should be captain. I didn't know whether he was going to be fullback or front row, but he hadn't decided where he wanted to play there. But anyhow, that was my first coaching of the Filipinas, and then it got to coaching Olsen, and what a thrill it was. what a thrill it was, and some of the things I saw in the men. But I suppose one story that I should share with you was in 1985 when we were playing Australia, and Olsen had the task of marking Wally Lewis, who was, you know, at the time arguably the number one player in the world in the eyes of many, particularly over there in Australia. And anyhow, the selectors at the time were a little bit reluctant about having Olsen at 5'8", and they had all sorts of silly reasons why they didn't want to do it. But I convinced them that Olsen was going to be the man. And anyhow, the next day I spoke to Olsen, and I arranged for him and I to go out and see his mum. Is it Sissy? Go out and see his mum, and because I wanted to have a talk to her. And so I sat down in the lounge, and we were having a cup of tea, and I said, "Oh, I just wanted to know if you can do me a favour, because, you know, this weekend Olsen is marking the best player in the world. And the thing is, some people think that Wally might be too good for him. And the thing is, if Olsen can't at least keep him at bay, we've got no chance against Australia." And I basically just said that. And Sissy got up and she went to Olsen and she said, "Olsen, you do exactly what Mr. Lowe says. All right, clip your ear. And it just... And it used to be funny as anything, because I was trying to do these firm team talks to the players about, you know, about who's marking who, and I'd say to Olsen, "Don't forget, I'll get your mum onto you." And people wondered why he got the best of Wally Lewis in that particular series. He was just such a great man. I wanted to read out something, but actually I didn't bring my blinking glasses. I forgot my glasses. So I won't read it out, because I'm trying to think of something to say about Olsen. I couldn't think of something. But there was a poem that I used to play to some music, and it's by Rudyard Kipling called "If," and Olsen used to love it. Olsen loved that poem. I can't read it out to you now, but maybe you might. Would you just mind just reading that? And just down to where I've got it marked. Just
for glasses. You've
got some glasses. Sweet. Yeah. Thank you.
This is what Fado is like.
Is that better? Sweet.
All right, because this poem by Rudyard Kipling, I used to play it to the players, because I thought it was a message to each one of them. But Olsen in particular used to love it. And I can share something that with you, that he came often on the day of the test matches. He used to come into my room, lay down on the bed, just listen with me, lay down on the bed and ask me to play this, and I'd have to play it on a video for him, just for him especially. The players didn't, the other guys didn't used to know it. But I think the words sum Olsen up in many ways. It says, "If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too, if you can wait and not be tired by waiting, or being lied about, don't deal in lies, or being hated, don't give way to hate, and yet be good, and yet don't look too good, nor talk too wise. If you dream and not make dreams your master, if you think and not make your thoughts your aims, if you can meet triumph and disaster and treat these two imposters just the same." They're just some of the words. The final words were, "If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings, nor lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but none too much, if you can fulfill an unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything in it, and which is more, you'll be a man, my son." And, you know, Patrick Skene did a wonderful thing for Olsen. Patrick Skene did a fantastic, he summed Olsen up in the Big O. He summed him up. He did an absolutely fantastic thing. And because many of us have tried to put into words what Olsen meant to us. Many of us have tried to say it, but we'll never capture it. And we'll think, gee, we should have said this. Gee, we should have said that. There was a commercial side I saw in Olsen as well. We were on tour in England. And I always smiled because he got up and gave a little bit of a team talk about particularly the younger guys, how they had to eat a balanced diet and how they had to have plenty of fruit. And then he mysteriously disappeared for a little while, and he came back, him and Dane Sorensen came back together, and they sold fruit to the young players to make sure they had the balance. They didn't give it to them, they sold it to them. So he had a good commercial side to him as well. But, you know, if you coach, you can only dream that you might be able to coach at some stage someone like Olsen Filipaina. You can only dream it. So sitting there are some of the best players that have ever pulled on a Kiwi jersey or an international jersey or a footy jersey of any type. Olsen will always sit amongst the absolute best in the top row. He was a champion man. I owe the man so much I could never ever pay it back. I owe the good things that happened to me for me as a coach. Olsen played a massive, massive role in that. I thank you, Olsen. I thank you, Olsen. And I hope over the years to come I can pay some of it back in some way. But to your family, Meredith, I do think you suit that name. My heart's been with you and bleeding. My heart's been bleeding, but you said some wise things to me that stopped the bleeding, Alpha, and I just thank you, because we do move on. We have to go on. We have to go on, and I have to move on now. Thank you for the opportunity to speak, and if we ever need a depiction or somebody who is ever going to represent what it meant to be a Kiwi rugby league player, you could never do any better than put Olsen up there. He is magic. I had a chat with Wally Lewis last year at the Fogs luncheon, and we were just talking about it, because it had only been in recent times that him and Wally had actually started talking to one another, because Wally had refused to shake Olsen's hand, I think, after one of the games. And so anyhow, they got it sorted out, and there's no issue. But Wally and I were talking about it, because Wally and I are pretty close as well. And he said he always remembers that particular series back in the 80s, because every time he looked in the mirror, there were another lot of sprig marks over him where Olsen had run over top of him on that side. He'd just sort of patch that lot up. The next weekend he'd look again, there's another lot down the other side. So what a great man, what a great friend, and what a great player, and what a great privilege it was for me to be his coach. Thank you.
You know the age of technology is here when there's the poem up on screen. So thank you for the back row out there. Our next speaker is going to be Gary Kimball. Thanks, Gary.
Well, it's all been said, isn't it? It's awesome. Thanks, Alf, and your whānau for letting me have a talk. Ollie, awesome memories, mate. Me and Ollie met in the 1960s, and that's how far we go back. And it's on the footy field, and the experiences that I will never forget. And it's a great experience. Over time, we got to know each other, and especially playing for Auckland in the schoolboy grades. Just about every year we met up, and I was glad of playing with him, of course. You know, it was great to meet up together. And I always remember when we used to go down to Waikato, and the bus used to stop at Otahu to pick up the Māori boys and the Otahu boys and the Papatoa boys, and then they stopped at Papakura to pick up us and the Manurewa boys. And every time, I can always remember, every time I got on that bus, okay, I had a look, and I looked at the bus, looking at everybody, and I saw Ollie, and I went, whew, oh, we're going to win today, man. And then, of course, you know, when you're playing Papakura, and then the draw comes up, and we're playing Manly East. Crap. And I always remember we had a game at Carlisle Park, and that's where you always aspire to be, is to play at Carlisle Park. And I always remember we played at a half-time game, you know, a seven-a-side. I can't remember if it was a seven-a-side or a ten-a-side. And I was playing second 5-8 then, and, of course, Ollie was playing centres as well, or second 5-8, you know, centre. And I'll never forget that when we first ran on the field, and, you know, well, you can just see what Ollie's like. You can imagine what I was like in those days. And he just used to, you know, his humble smile just before we played and everything like that. And, of course, player of the day, Olsen Filipaina. And then he comes off, but the things I always remember about him is he'll give you a big hug, you know, and give you, it doesn't matter how well they played, doesn't matter how well you played, he just came up and, hey, thanks, great game, you know, all the time. We each progressed to, of course, to the Premiers. We played for Manly East, and then I actually went on to play for Ellerslie and had a few good battles. And then, of course, got selected for the Auckland team. And when we met up with that Auckland team in 1977, the boys here, we just created such a great bond. And, you know, and every time we meet each other, we'd just hug and we'd smile at each other. We're sort of saying, well, you know, we're here now, and but the rest of the players in that team really created a special bond, and you can just imagine how Olsen was part of that. He was one of the leaders of that, and from then on, I think rugby league, especially in Auckland and New Zealand, progressed really, really well because of that bond that we had in that 77 team, and they were memories that you'll never, ever, ever forget. And of course, then you know, we met up every time to go on tour with either Auckland, you know, the Amco Cups and stuff like that, and the Kiwis. And then later in life, you know, when we met up, it was exactly the same. You know, Ollie would just big hugs, big smile to each other, things that you'll never ever forget. And we didn't have to say anything because we knew we're going to have a great time. We knew we're going to win this game. If we didn't win that game, we're going to give our 100%, because, you know, it was a special moment when we got together. And I couldn't wait to get back from the UK. The boys couldn't wait to get back from the UK. The guys from Australia said the same thing, and Ollie said the same thing. He couldn't wait to get back from Australia to be amongst us boys and brothers, you know, and it was a great feeling. And that is memories that you never forget. So, we experienced a lot together, and he will always be special in my life, and, you know, I think in a lot of people's lives, and I thank you, Ollie, for the opportunities that you gave me to be together, especially on and off the field.
Our next speaker is listed here by the man whose name I won't use, is Selwyn, aka Bunny. Where's the house?
Well, Olsen, I'm going to talk for an hour because I'm going to get this bloody mask off, so I'll be talking for a while, I think, so that I can keep the mask here. But anyway, kia ora whānau, te whānau here. My name is Selwyn Rickety, nicknamed Benny, and I'm from Rotorua, Ngāti Pigiao, and I founded the Pigiao Rugby League Club in 1977. In 1980, We had a great 3 years and won the grand final over there. We decided after all of that, whānau comes first. I looked at my family and really we had nothing at that time. So we decided to go to Sydney. A cousin of mine was over visiting home down at Auckland Falls, Maria, and she said, you know, you really should come over. She was working at the Ryde Eastford Leagues Club. She knew Phil Dryers and Margaret Dryers, where Olsen was being billeted. And she says, come over and play for the club, Ryde Eastford, or trial out with them. So I thought, yeah, I'd do that. And so I left. And our people, it was short notice to our people down there. And we needed to go and, you know, hence the story, the start in Sydney. So I'd just like to acknowledge, you know, first a couple of people. Elf, when I rang you, you said, yeah, come along. And, you know, the best thing ever to let me spend a night with Olsen, sleep by his side, have a tangi with your nephews and your nieces, something I'll never forget. Because really, I suppose my friendship with him was under the radar. You know, when all the hoopla and the games were finished, you know, he'd ring me up. Hey, bro, yeah. We're going to go down the pub. Oh, okay, right, hey. And then we'd go and have a talk about the game. I think that also I'd want to just acknowledge all the people in Aussie, all my mates in Ryde, Larry Corowa, all those ex-Balmain players, and my two boys, my two sons that are there, George and Dean, who Olsen was like a father to. And I just heard Graham talk about 1982 when he came over. They actually went out to Penrith with Olsen. I think you might remember that, and you guys went on my old van with my family, with my kids and my wife. So, you know, that was a big thing for me. So I just, you know, Olsen was a guy to me. There was three tiers. Number one, his international family, the international team, and that great, amazing atmosphere that, you know, who I sort of say is Graham Lowe, who's got to be New Zealand's greatest coach. And that family, he was a different man when he went along to the Kiwi games, functions, and I saw all that. Then it comes down to his club, and I thought there was a bit of employment for him. He come from a family, international, and he come down to his club, you know, which he couldn't bring that closeness and that family trait into his club football. So they were good mates. You know, I knew a lot of them because went along to a lot of the games. And then I think the appeal of Olsen in Australia was the working class people. It was all those silent people that went about their work every day, worked hard, tradespeople, carpenters, plumbers, all those kind of people. They loved him. He was their hero. Whenever you went to a game, Olsen always had time to go around and get autographs signed by all the children at Leichhardt Oval. And, you know, when he was in his truck, people would wave out to him. He'd take me out at Christmas time because there's a lot of beers, you know, whenever you emptied people's garbage bin. So I'd be running behind the truck and getting all the Christmas presents, all the beers and cakes and all that sort of stuff. So, you know, for me, that's where I come into to his life, and Leslie knows we were very, very close. So you had his international whānau, You had his club players, then you had his mates. So when I went over there, I was a friend because I met him at the Riders for Leagues Club and I was a friend. So we're feeling each other out. You know, where's this guy from? I knew who he was because I used to read all his clippings when he was playing in Auckland. And a fantastic player. He didn't know who I was. And so we started talking rugby league. And sort of slowly, you know, we built this little bit of a relationship. And then we started playing tennis. And so, you know, I'd get close to him, 6'4", 6'5", 6'4", 6'5". And we played every Tuesdays and Wednesdays. So because I worked in the weekends, he'd ring me up on Tuesday. You're right. Yeah, all right. So he'd be up since 4 o'clock in the morning. And, you know, then we'd meet down at the tennis court and play from about 8 o'clock to about 12. And so then we got this bond. I played for Ryde Eastwood. He'd come and watch me. I'd go and watch him. And then I moved up from a friend to a mate. Okay, so when you're a mate, you get involved a little bit more with his family. And he used to take me along to the after-match functions whenever Balmain were playing. And then, surprise, surprise, he introduced me to Frank Stanton, old Biscuits Grumpy Frank Stanton. He said, "This is my brother." So I let him in, because you couldn't get into those after-match functions. So then I became his brother. Right, wherever we went, I was his brother. Oh, okay, so I've advanced from a friend to a mate to a brother. And that's when I really got to know his family, got to know Leslie and the kids, and he was like a father to my boys. They loved him. And so did all their mates. Everybody used to come around to our place, swim in the pool and everything like that, and all the kids, all the friends, Olsen's going to be there. And they all loved him. So, you know, that was him. That's how I knew him. And, you know, when you look at the effect that he had on you know, the teams that he played, I mean, you know, he's just an unbelievable man. I sort of rate Aboriginal football players, rugby league players, as right up there, because they're the types of people, of players, of athletes that can get on the paddock. And I'm talking about the lower grades, not up in the international stuff. And up in the international stuff, they are even better. But in the lower grades, you know, a good mate of mine, Len Smith, he's the father of Tyron Smith, and he was coaching in Mascot. And he said to me, "Oh, come down, Selwyn, come down and motivate the boys," because we're pretty good in those days, a bit of motivation, talking about our people and all that. And come and motivate the boys, and they're playing this Aboriginal side, La Perouse. He said, "You want to watch them, Selwyn?" I said, "Okay." He said, "They've probably been out on a drink all night, probably get home at 4 o'clock in the morning, and when you see them run onto the paddock, they're half asleep. But," he said, "after half time, when they wake up, you want to watch the magic." And you could see the magic. They knew where to run to. They knew where the weaknesses was. It was like the hunter-gatherer in them. They're an old, old breed. And nothing flash, nothing but the speed, their agility, their balance, and the hands. Unbelievable. So I looked at Olsen, and I'm thinking, he's a big Aboriginal. You know, he's 115 kilogram Aboriginal the way he plays. His hands, his balance, his speed. You know, well, not so much speed, but certainly, you know, the presence on the paddock must have scared a lot of players. So I just want to keep it nice and short. Don't want to go too long and everything. So I just, some stories. And Leslie knows we did a lot of crying as families and arguing too, and this and that and the other thing, and but we were like a family, living out of each other's pockets, and I can remember a time Olsen rang me up. He said, "Oh, listen, well, you know, can you come with me?" I said, "Well, where are we going?" He said, no, just come along." Okay. So we ended up at this prison place not in Parramatta, in Silverwater. He said, "Can you lend me $5,000? Jesus, $5,000, bro. He said, "Oh, I'm going to put $5,000 in, you put $5,000 in, and we're going to get the young fella out of jail." I said, "Oh, what?" So anyway, we went along there to the place and spoke to the young fella. And after he said, I'm okay. You know, leave me here." So Olsen and I drove home, disgusted. But anyway, here's some stories that I'd like to talk about. And one of them is tennis. And I worked at City Ford, which Nick Politis owns. He owns most of the City Ford dealerships in Sydney. I think everybody knows who Uncle Nick is. And at that time, I was working in Parramatta at Thompson Ford, and our dealer principal was Alan Butcher. And he invited Olsen and I out to go and play tennis with him and his son. And so we drive out there to Terry Hills, beautiful, plush, you know, manicured lawns, trees, all that sort of stuff. The tennis court is beautiful, green. And, you know, you see on the side there, they had 6 rackets each and new balls and nice drinks on the side. And Olsen and I get out there, "What's this?" And we started playing. And this is the humbleness of Olsen. And then what I call his controlled intensity. Not controlled aggression. I thought he was never aggressive on the paddock. He was intense, and it was controlled. So anyway, we started playing, and the opposition got these headbands on. They're running around and pumping their fists and carrying on. And you know, we were halfway through that first set, and they're up to sort of like 4 love. And I'm looking at my mate. He's looking at me, and I'm so. Anyway, they won the first set 6 love. And so they had a bit of a break and hugged each other, father and son, very happy, pumping their fists and all that. And I said to Olsen, I said, "Mate, what's going on?" He said, "What do you mean?" I said, "What is going on with you?" He said, "Well, isn't he the big boss? You know, if we beat them, you might lose your job." And I said, "I don't care about my job, man. I want to beat them." So then, you know, Olsen had that knack of just lifting up. His serves were probably going in at 50 or 60 K. And in the second set, right, he builds those up to 80 or 90 Ks. And the opposition and the dealer principal and his son are saying, "Oh, you know, what's that?" So such was the man. He could just lift up the levels. And at any rate, we ended up winning the second set. And we won the third set, and there was no drinks after or anything like that. We had to get in our cars and go home because the dealer principal wasn't very happy. So that was our tennis. And one of the other stories is meeting Sissy. And everybody knows about Mad Mondays. And in those days, Olsen and I used to go out. This particular year, I'd won a few Man of the Match awards from Wentworthville. And so you cash them in at the end of the year, and Olsen had just come off, and we decided to go to for dinner at Wentworthville Leagues. Beautiful, Leslie and first wife Bertha. We all went there and then had a few more drinks, and we went up to a nightclub called War and Peace, where a couple of our good mates were, the bouncers on the door. And then after that, we sent the wives home, and Olsen and I decided to go out on the drink. We had a couple of drivers there, and we didn't return for about 3 days. So all the way down, everybody knows him. I mean, everybody that knows Olsen, if you're going out for a drink with him, you know, you get to the place and you hardly see him. I mean, everybody else talks to him. At any rate, we got home, and that was my first meeting with Sissy. Never met her before, and as soon as we walked in the door, she unloaded on me. You know, four-letter words and this, that, the other thing. I'd never met her before. And telling me, you know, you're no good, blah, 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 blah. So after about 5 minutes of that, you know, and then she unloaded on Olsen, and then she said to me, if you're a good mate of his, you're naughty. So that was it. That was my entrance to Sissy. The last little story that him and I had, karaoke. I can't beat Olsen in tennis. We had a touch football side as well. We called ourselves NZs. Mark Graham was playing. A couple of the Balmain boys were playing for us. We had a pretty good side. We had some Lebanese, and we had the Lose boys. Pretty good. But anyway, karaoke. So he rang me up and he said, we're going down, there's a fundraiser for Narrowena. They were in Manly. There's a fundraiser. They're raising money for schoolboys coming back to Mangere East. I said, okay, we'll go. So anyway, we get down there and, you know, this is a serious karaoke. I think there was $750 first prize in. It's a serious karaoke show. Everybody's practicing in toilets and this and that and the other thing. They're not drinking. I'm having plenty of drinks and all that. At any rate, we started and we got to the last three. And it was me and two other people who were very, very serious, and I was probably drunk. And anyway, we sang songs, and the last song I sang, which has got us into the grand final, was 10 Guitars, the Maori National Anthem. Anyway, I got the first prize, and so I went back to my chair, and Olsen looked at me, I looked at him, and we're looking at each other. And I said, what? And he says, what? I said, what? So what he was saying was that give the money back to them. So I did, and that was Olsen again. So I went back, gave the $750 back to the club so that they could, you know, come for a trip to Mangere East. So that's just a short, you know, little story about Olsen, but, you know, and Leslie. In the old days, my wife used to work with Leslie at the Riders with Lee's Club and how we met. So I just think, you know, a genius, a magician on the football paddock, and just a natural. So I'm going to finish up by singing a couple of songs anyway. Or maybe one, I don't know. One. And, you know, this is for my mate because he's, you know, in the opposition was getting into him, hitting him hard and all that sort of, he just keeps smiling. He just keeps smiling. So I'm going to sing that song, eh? Yep. Okay. When you're smiling, you can all sing. When you're smiling, the whole world smiles at you. When you're laughing, the sun comes shining through. When you're smiling, the whole world keeps smiling at you. That's that song. One more song. And Olsen and I used to sing this every time. It was a go-to song, you know, whenever you went to a Māori thing in Sydney. So it's one that everybody knows, and we'll just sing it. I'll try my best. Pō kare kare a nā, nā wai a rotoru a, pitu atu koe hine, marino ana e hine. Hoki mai rā, kama te aho, beautiful. I te aroha e, te aroha e. Kia ora.
Okay. So Selwyn's put the challenge out. But I want to put Wero out. When we opened the service, the team from Otahuhu College did our karakia and our haka. And so before we hand it back to Alf, I'd like to make sure that maybe somebody from Otahuhu College is able to come up and speak. So if you can whai korero amongst yourselves to figure out who's got the short straw, we'll invite you to come up before Alf does.
It's still okay for the open session.
Yep. So, the open floor. Anyone else? Everyone else? Oh. We were warned about this.
I promise not to sing, because my mate here will start kicking the box and tell me to get the hell out of it. I could say a few things of tours with Olsen, and I don't have to say what a great player he was, and what a great gentleman he was, and what a great mate he was. Because, I was just honoured to know him. And those of us that played with him, against him, toured with him, we just all had the utmost respect for him. Some of the things we saw him do on the footy field, you know, you had to be there to believe it. You know. He was just that sort of guy, you know. So I don't have to say a lot. I could tell you a few stories, by God, but yeah. I might get censored. But No, and all the family, I'll be going back up to Kaikui and that, and we'll lay them to rest. But I suppose, one thing I do want to say is down at the front there, there's a, when Carlo Park was pulled out, they had shields, wooden shields. I think there were 300 that were made. By chance, I had two. By chance. So when he was back in Tennessee, I went over there and had it under my arm and said, you know, I want this to go with Olsen. And Alfie said, no, we got one here. And I said, well, you keep that for the whānau. I said, that's, don't worry about this one. And then he starts hitting me up about stolen property going with his brother. And I'm like, I'm the most honest cop that ever served the New Zealand police. Close to it anyway. But no, that is going to be buried with Olsen is on behalf of this 77 Auckland side. And for those of you that don't know, you know, that was I played a lot of games with them and that, but that's probably the team that got the best results. We knocked over the Aussies, the Poms and the bloody Frenchmen in 3 weeks back in 77, the Auckland side. And this year's 45 years since that. And out of the 19 players, Buddy Olsen won the first one out. So Olsen's the first one of those 19 players. So whether Bill Sorensen and Bill Nesbitt and those, you know, they picked the good side, but they also picked the side that had longevity. So the rest of us are still hanging in there. And whenever we meet, this fella here will be mentioned. But that shield is from us. I think, I'm presenting it from us. But for everyone that played with Mahina East, against Olsen, Auckland, Kiwis, there will always be a part of Carlo Park with them. And that means a lot. Yeah, and Alfie, I can assure you it is not stolen. You know, people give me things and I acquire things and I save them for special moments. But I do acknowledge all the Filipaina whānau. He was like a brother. You know I loved him. and I know how he felt, our thing. So, yep, we'll get him up home, we'll get him with Sissy and get him with Chew. And looks like I've got a good selection of jerseys to pick from. He'll be safe. And yeah, I better shut up because he'll start really going off, because he'll just shut up, Lindsay, and go home. But no, we'll look after him, we'll take him home, we'll lay him to rest, and we will always have memories of this guy, you know, anyone that knew him. And I'm not going to sing because I can't. Yeah, so I'm honest. Anyway, I'll leave it at that. But yeah, everyone take care. Rest in peace, my man. When we get up there, we've still got a couple of days of the journey left. Yeah. I passed that ball to him just before that. I ran from the 5 metres out. I got over the 25, I bumped a few off. Ended a couple, gave it to Olsen. He did a dummy, scored a try.
Hey, Lindsay, it's not about you.
Oh, sorry. He's got the try, he got the points. I'm out of here. And Meredith, thanks very much for that.
Ka tangi te tūti, ka tangi te kāka, ka tangi huki a hau tī hei mauriola. Tēnei te mihi ki a koutou e tēnei wā, tēnei te mihi ki te rangatira o Tāhuhu College, mēne ngā tauira ano hoki mō tō karakia me haka pōhiri i tēnei wā. Ki te whānau mark, me whānau pani, kaha aroha nunui ki a koutou i tēnei wā. Ai, ka aroha, ka aroha, ka aroha. I tupu aki au, ki Kaikoe, Elf. I tupu aki ki taku tōku kuia me koro, koro. I Kaikoe, nō reira e rua, nā Kiwis mai i Kaikoe, ko Olsen, ko au. Ah, he hariko au i te mōhi au ki a kōrua tahi. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa. I'll keep it pretty short. Just some condolences from Shane Price, the chairman of the Auckland Rugby League, who couldn't make it today. Unfortunately, he had to stay at home with COVID, but sends his aroha and his condolences to everybody here, and everyone, of course, from the Auckland Rugby League and all the clubs of Auckland who we represent. I've counted three people that wore that jersey after Olsen in the room today. Myself, Tia, and Mutu. Have I missed anyone? I don't think so. In some prestigious company, that jersey that Olsen wore before us. I'm like Tawhid, I got a book from Olsen too. He sent me, I was real humbled to be able to write in that book, because Olsen did so much for us in his time when he played over in Balmain in Australia. He wrote to me, "I have to say something else to all the other players, Kempi, but you were the best that I like to watch." Don't tell Tawhid. But he was, when I was growing up, I grew up as a kid watching Westie, Brucey Gore, and Howie Tamari from my home in Taranaki. But Westie was a back rower, Howie was a hooker that tackled around the ankles, and Gawley was just nuts. We didn't have a 5'8", and the person that I loved to watch when I was growing up was Olsen, because he was the first of the big 5'8s that came out. And as you know, tēnei tangata kāore o puto, you know, so is he sort of gave me that aspiration to wear the number 6 jersey, which was the jersey that I always wanted to wear for the Kiwis. And I've had a number of conversations with Olsen just thanking him. I sometimes pinch myself that I'm talking to Olsen, you know what I mean? And then I got to play alongside Tawera and Tia and those types of players as I was growing up. But when I reflect on it, our mate Olsen, for all of us Māori Pacifica kids, lay that huarahi for us, that road for us to follow. So tēnei te mihi ki a koe, Olsen. Moi mai rā e te rangatira. Ka haere ki te ukai pō, ka haere ki te turanga waiwai, ki kai koe. Nō reira, moi mai rā ki Hawaiki Nui, ki Hawaiki Roa, ki Hawaiki Pāmāmā. Tēnā koutou katoa. Just going to put this on, yeah, it's just a coat of arms from the Auckland Rugby League on behalf of the Auckland Rugby League.
Haere mai. Otherwise, Meredith might come forward. Yeah. When you go up to Kaikohe, you go up to the marae, make sure you find out where that name came from.
I know where it came from. It's from Kings.
Coming behind such prestigious company, I don't know what. So my name is V. I was asked by Sonia and Jerry to get up and speak on behalf of Sonia's family, the Lee family. To none of them could be here today for COVID and other things. But they just wanted me to express their condolences of not being able to come here, Alf, and to share with the Filipaina family, and on behalf of her father, John, and to just, you know, reiterate what everyone else has said about Olsen and what a fantastic person he was. He was so humble. They just, you know, loved watching all the old video shots of when he was playing, and yeah, just wanted to express their condolences and the fact that they couldn't be here today. But I was privileged to get to know Olsen maybe just 5 or 6 years ago. I didn't know him in his heyday, although I knew Alf. I've known Alf for such a long time. But I was privileged to be at the table with Olsen during the writing of his book, and he was sharing some of the stories that came, you know, that he was involved with, and I was just in awe of this humble man, and he was very articulate in explaining and remembering everything that went on during his career, and the memorable times that he had. And also what stood out for me was the racism that he endured when he first went over to Australia, being a Samoan Māori and, you know, and classed as black. But Olsen just, he was there to play league. He wasn't there about politics, he just loved the game. And he wanted to represent New Zealand and his team in the best way that he could. And so that's, you know, sitting at the table with him and Patrick at the time, that was just a really special honour for me. Unfortunately, that was the last time I saw Olsen. But, yeah, just a fantastic, absolutely fantastic man. And I was privileged to call him a friend and a brother. So thank you very much.
Te taira.
kai pō. Ka karanga tō whānau o te taituke rau ki a koe. Hare mai, haere. Haere, kei waina nui ngā te whare tapu o ngā puhi. Hei reira e takato ana tō whāia, tō teina. O koutou nei whānau. O reira e kara. O korewe e mutu ngā mihi ki a koe. Kua tai mai te iti me te rahi. I roto ngā rā e rua e pahurene. O reira ka tūpakiti tēnei uri o ngā titureti. Kua tai, hei wainanui a ngā kau tēnei. Tēnei rangi. Reira e kautokanga ngā mihi, kua mihia. Whare āre kia o kota tau te peropero te tuakuti. E pāura, e rā te mihi, e te atika, e rā, a te ki, ire, tai mārangi. Reira, a kā nuku nuku, kā neke neke. Kā nuku nuku, kā neke neke. I hiro ki ngā tai o tuke rau i hora nei. E he pipi i wharau roa. Takato te pai. I takato te pai. Piti, piti, tāta, tāta. Piti, piti, tāta, tāta. E rā taua ki tua. Takato te pai. I takato te pai. E re Olsen. Ai aku koe. Ai ki te rā kāinga tūturu mō tāua nei te tāngata. I hawai ki nui, hawai ki rua, hawai ki tāmama. O reira ka huri anō te whānau whānu. Aha koa ngā piki me ngā heke. Ka pupuri tonu. I te matua nei te rangi ki timatanga me te whaotinga o ngā mea katoa. O reira, kororia tōna ingoa tapu. Ongre kororia. A ngā rongo ki runa te matua te metua, e whakāro pai i ngā tāmata katoa. E aku rauranga tira mā, i tonu, ki a tāmata katoa, Rene Olsen. O pā, o pā, o pā, anu ieo tau kumaraka. E aku rauranga tira mā, kua tai mai i kāre ki o tā huhu nei rā te mihi. Ki tēnei uri o ngā kupāta, e tū whakeiti i mui a kautau. Tēnei waiwai mai te kaipara, tēnei waiwai mai pāngare i tēri ngā pāo, no nā ki hau, no reira mihi tonu ki a tātou katoa. Nā mā tā waka, nā rangatira, o mua, te whananga o kai kohe kohe kua tai mai nei. So reira, hei rā te mini ki a tātou katoa. I roto te whare, no reira, huri no, tēnā koutou. Tēnā koutou. Tēnā tātou katoa. E waiata mai, mai te whare, mai te kura rātaku. Nā, o tēnei te waiata. Ka haere pahi tātou ki te oranga, ki te oranga, ki te oranga. Ka haere pahi tātou ki te oranga, ki te kua, kua, kua. You follow my notice. Come along with me to my father's house, to my father's house, to my father's house. Come along with me to my father's house, where there's joy, joy, joy. That after me, Yahweh, in Meredith. There's a funny story about that.
Ko te mihi tuatahi ki te atua, nā, e anganga mea katoa. Te whare atu nei a tēnā koe. Ka mihi atu ki te kingi Māori tu heitia me tono hōranga tira me tā rau a whānau hoki, pai Māori re ki a rātou. Ki a koe te rangatira, e tuakana, e Olsen, haere, haere, haere atu rā. Ngā mate, ko te mihi. Ngā mate ngā tini ai tua koutou ki a koutou ko hoki mai ki a tātou te hinga ora tēnā koutou e tēnā tātou katoa. Whātora whātu le pa ia, ma le mamalu o leo fia o āpata poto e le nei aso whaftei le atua. Ko Filipaina taku inga, ko Sisi Remana toku māma no Ngapuhi, ko Aloese ai le lō te Vita Filipaina toku pāpa no Hāmoa, ko Ngāti Mahia te hapu, ko Ngāti Hāmo te iwi, no reira tēnā koutou, a tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa. Look, there's a trend that you obviously are hearing, and it's the word Meredith. I just want to explain the origin of the word Meredith. It comes from the ancient kings that roamed this land, and only a few people have Meredith as their second Christian name. I think from memory, I'm the only one that has Meredith as their second Christian name. So look, my job here, and the trend also starts with my tuakana, Joe, and then with Dana, with Philip, the younger brother. As you could see, when they came up to speak, we were slowly getting smaller. And I am the smallest out of the three of them. So there was a trend there as well. I want to firstly acknowledge the family and the family in Australia. Why? Because they allowed the journey that Olsen went on with the Sikui. They allowed him to come home. So I want to acknowledge Jerry and Sonia and V. That's why I wanted to do that. Jerry and Sonia, the brother is over there with his wife. I want to acknowledge him. I want to acknowledge all our whānau from my dad's side. I want to acknowledge them. I want to acknowledge Leslie. Leslie went over. She spent about 12 days with talking to the family to get Olsen back. And that job was done. So I want to acknowledge you, Leslie, and also to acknowledge our nieces and nephews over there. You've got Louise, Quinn, and John to Leslie. And then you've got Alicia and Jasmine to Debbie. I want to acknowledge them. I also want to acknowledge Marcia Matuakiri. Matuakiri was there at the Sydney tribute, and he was their kaumātua there. So I want to acknowledge him. I want to acknowledge Marcia's daughter, Naomi, and all the work that they did over there for the tribute session that they did. I also wanted to just give you some whakapapa to the waka that Olsen's in at the moment, and which is going to go up home up to Awurua. Our marae is to Huruhi. It's on Otainga Road, which is off the, which is off Mangakahia Road, heading up towards Kaikoe. So the family and the vision for the casket was that when Olsen came back home, and he came back home last Wednesday, and when he came back home, we took him to the marae at the airport because it was important that he ended up going there to be welcomed back. It was just so important we did that. There's a connection with that marae. And it's te mā nukunuku o Hoturoa Māori marae. And mana whenua is te akatai wai uhua. So the importance to going back to that marae for Olsen to at least have a karakia and then a blessing, the importance was because there's a connection with mana whenua, with the Wilsons, who ended up going to OC with Olsen and myself and the other brothers. The other connection is the whare tupuna that is named after Sonia's great-grandmother. That's Jerry's wife. So it was important. We then wanted Olsen to go into his own casket. So then his journey up home is in a new waka. If you have a look, and especially when the boys, the 1977 side brought him in, on the top is Margaret East, where he started. And it had to be there, up the top. Then the next one is the Auckland Rugby League. Not only for the games that he played, but the acknowledgement of the 1977 side. And Lindsay ended up telling you what happened in that year. So that's why the ARL is on there. Not only because of the province that he played for with many of the people that are here, but also for the fact of the 1977 side. The next logo down from that is Samoan Rugby League. Because way back in the day, and as for those that remember, 1988, Olsen played for Western Samoan, it was known at the time. He represented our father's country of birth, and he played in the Pacific Cup. Now, way back in the day, he didn't understand Samoan, and his playing mates didn't understand English. So Olsen asked him, he was telling me the story, and he says, look, I want to learn some Samoan words so I can at least talk to some of the players. So the original words they gave him were all swear words. He then found out they were swear words, and he says, look, there's only two words I want to learn, is pass the ball and just set me up. So the two words they learnt was seki, which is set it up, and pasipolo. That was the only two words. They lost the final in 1988 to the New Zealand Māori, and Olsen was named the tournament player. At his feet end is the New Zealand Kiwi emblem. That emblem, and Greg, I acknowledge you as the CEO of NZRL for the permission for us to use their Kiwi logo, because that was Olsen. That was our brother, and it was the Kiwis. That's where his heart was. And so we've got that at the top on his casket. If you have a look, we've got the New Zealand Rugby League logo. Why? Again, we want that when we especially take him up home for people to see, because that was his heart. Started in Margaret East, but his heart was New Zealand Rugby League, putting that silver fern on. At the top end, at the head, is the Margaret East one. On this side, what you've got are the teams, the logos that Olsen played for. One is Balmain Tigers, the first one that he went over. He then played for North Sydney, and then he played for Eastern Suburbs. They couldn't find a logo with Eastern Suburbs, so they put that logo over there on the side where Leslie is, and they got the Sydney Roosters.
Right Eastward is the one that him and Clayton played in the Metropolitan Cup, the inaugural Metropolitan Cup, which they won. So Right Eastward is there. The only difference on this side is that we have the emblem of the Kaikohe Lions Rugby League. Why? Because when Olsen went up with Patrick and Lowy mentioned the book and Patrick the author, they went up north, up home, and they spoke to Ken, who was the chair at Kaikohe Lions, and when Olsen went up there, they presented him with a jersey and also made him patron of the Rugby League Club. So out of respect to the Kaikohe Lions, we've got the emblem on this side only. There's also, in Samoan custom, there's an adze or a weapon that's up there. Now, in the Samoan custom, there is a lot of names for this. But the principal at Sutton Park Primary, which we all went to, he presented that to Olsen. And we had our Cook Island relatives come over and they explained, and they said for them that's a toki from them, and then they explained in Aotataki that the toki with their legend that was used to pave a way through coral, and their pathway for them was to pave it straight, and they did with what they termed that to be a toki, and that symbolised for us that Olsen's pathway to home is going to be a straight line. That's where he's going to go. He's going to lay there tonight, and then on Wednesday we will have one day for our whānau up at Te Tai Tokerau to pay their respects, and then he'll have a service at 10 o'clock on Thursday. He will then be laid with my mum and our younger brother Ray on Thursday straight after the service. There's also Aboriginal talking sticks. They were presented to Quinn, Olsen's boy, and Quinn put them with Olsen, so they're going to be buried as well with him when we get back up home. I won't take that long, but like I said, my role is to thank people for everything, for the words that you've spoken. Tawara, I mihi to you. Why? Because I know Olsen spoke about you quite a bit, and that book, along with Tony's book and a lot of others that I've had, I've got more to. We decided, because we said to Olsen, look, we want to get these signed because it's important for you to acknowledge your teammates. So those are the ones that you got through that came over home, and then Troy sent them to you. So if you can, because I want to get a montage together, just get a photo with the book, please. And just send it through to my email. I just want to get a montage so at least the whānau have it. Of the people who received the book. Mutu, I think I still got yours. So then at some stage you can shout me to Yamcha, and that's when I'll give you the book. To all the others who I've got the book, same will apply. Just shout me Yamcha. Look, that jersey is something that I know a lot of people would want, but it's going to be buried with Ollie. It will. Lowy, I've said to Lowy what just our acknowledgements to him. Gary was part of. We had a video chat when Olsen was in ICU, and you know Olsen was in ICU for 16 days, but what had happened was. We ended up having the chat, and Louise was organising that for us, you know, just to sort of talk to Olsen, just sort of acknowledge him and talk to him. Gary was part of that. So Gary, to you, I mihi to you, my brother. Thank you so much on behalf of the whole family, because having you on there and seeing your brother was just testament to us around how close you were. The other people as well that came on there was Mark Graham. There was also Fred Arcoy that ended up talking to Olsen. Mark Troyer was there, and also there was Sir Peter Charles Leachy. Our history goes back to
geez, I think the 60s, I think, AJ, with Leachy, way back in the 60s. And I remember Peter being at home when the officials from Balmain were talking to Mum and Dad about Olsen's contract. Peter has been there. He is a family friend. He is just so close to us. It's not funny. So I just want to acknowledge Peter as well. Larry Corowa, it was awesome that he was on the same call that, you know, and what he shared with us, which was so cool for us to hear, was that when Olsen first went into the changing room at Balmain Tigers, he went straight to Larry. He sat next to Larry. He just said, and from then on, they were just brothers. And he just sort of gravitated to Larry. I want to acknowledge Manuka Memorial Gardens and also Daryl, who's in the back with the AV. Why? Because Daryl ended up putting this up. He also got the video that's going to be shown after I acknowledge everybody. And, you know, Selwyn, I thank you for the words that you shared, and also that night. We got a brief from one of our nieces, Sheena, about how things went that night. They ended up having a few quiet ones that night, and Binny stayed and hugged Olsen all night. So, Binny, I want to acknowledge you. Lindsay, you are a brother from a different mother, and the whole family. I mean, the utmost respect to you, because you've always been there. For those that don't know, Lindsay actually went with Olsen to Tipene Funerals to get him into his new waka. And so, Lindsay, we from all of us as the family, thank you so much for doing that, as we then prepared Tennessee Ave for that. Tony, again, just with the history with you and the words that you spoke here. So, you know, for us, that emblem again is going to be with the logo that's on top of the of Olsen's casket. So, ngā mihi ki a koe to you. V, you know, I mean, Jerry and Sonia are close to us. They were there and got Olsen back with the help of Leslie. But look, he's back here. He's in the right place, and for us to go up home. I think that the last thing, and I just really want this, and I wanted to mention everybody on this list, and I'm just going to call their names out because I, on behalf of the family, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for those that spoke. And I've already mentioned Tawera, Greg Peters, Otu Tony, Nadine Conlon, Lowy, Shane Cooper, Hugh McGann, Graham West, Nolan Tupaya, Dan O'Hara, Lindsay Proctor, Neville Kesha. Neville, you were just a big part of Mum and Dad's life, you and your family. So I just want to acknowledge you, Neville, because you were. I think you were the result of why my parents were alcoholics. So, yeah.
Got, story.
Yeah. Got Gary Kimball, Stephanie, Mark Gillespie, Shane Price, obviously the apologies were put in, Tony Kemp, Tasha Tasmania, Mark Lowe, Alan McCarthy, Graham Coots, Dave Lepper, Dan O'Hara, Dennis Williams, Nick Wright, James Watford, Morris Watford, Moana Tuiasau, Wai Parone, Ruben Wiki, Tia Roparty, Bruce Gore, Dwayne Mann, Logan Swan, Francis Leota. Look, I know some of them didn't come through, but these were the people that wanted to share what we have today. To our whānau that are here, I just want to say thank you so much for the last, how many days now? It's not even a week yet, but the fact that we all got things ready for Olsen to get back. I just want to acknowledge all our family, Maurice. You know, sometimes when you start with a name and you go, uh-oh, because you might miss some people. So just to everybody,
Kath, I just want to acknowledge you because one of the hardest parts for us was getting the food ready. And so Kathy ended up catering for us in the first two, three days. And that just eased everybody into it. But all our cousins, everybody else, I mihi to you. I know that our rangatira here is going to let everybody know what happens from here. But to our kaiako, to our rangatira, ngā mihi ki a koe, to our students at OC, ngā mihi ki a koutou katoa. Big ups to you. And this video will highlight what everybody has been talking about, which is our rangatira, which is Olsen. So I think that's next. Yeah. So Daryl, just to let you know, Daryl, thank you so much. Daryl got this off the, oh, he got it. It's just like Lindsay's ARL shield. he just got it. So look, nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou kato. Kia ora.
Murray looking for Pierce and passed it away to Filipaina. And Filipaina now, a one-handed pass back for Dan O'Hara. First test match of Lane Park. Lost to Frank and Luai, and then on the Filipaina we know again. Filipaina over the halfway mark.
Points too, so the Kiwis leave Australia 6-0 at the Sydney Cricket Ground. many people can get a closing waiata like that, eh? So, thank you everybody who's contributed. Thank you as we just close together. Shortly, I'll do a karakia. And then I, even though everything that's up here has been blessed, I'm going to bless it as a whole, because we want to take it as a whole out. At that point, the whānau and the pallbearers, do the pallbearers know, or is it a first in, first grab?
Okay.
We will take them outside and put them in the hearse. At that point, that's for those who are not going up with him to the home. That's your chance to do your last farewells. And there will be some flowers out there to put with him. You can say your last words, and they're not going to be recorded or broadcast. And we invite you to do that. When he leaves from here, he will be going straight up north. So this is our final gathering, our final prayer, our final memory of Olsen Filipaina here in Auckland, in Manukau. So I invite us to stand as we say our final karakias. We commend Olsen to God as he journeys beyond our sight. God of all consolation, in your unending love and mercy, you turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life. Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying for us, conquered death, and by rising again, restored life. May we not be afraid of death, but desire to be with Christ, and after our life on earth, to be with those we love, where every tear is wiped away and all things are made new. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you to join with me in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Now for each of us as we gather, as we go forward, now to the one who can keep us from falling and set us in the presence of the divine glory, jubilant and above reproach, to the only God, our Saviour, be glory and majesty, might and authority, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Creating God, as we gather, we bless each of these gifts that travels with Olsen, that they are sealed with him in journey as part of the gifts from everyone as we send him forth. We ask that you will take with him these stories and these memories in your name. Amen. The family would like to go and gather up the pieces, and the pallbearers gather around the casket.
Station. Yeah. Ricky.
Thank you.
saving grace. I love you, but Jesus loves you best. I bid you good night, good night, good night. I bid you good night, good night, good night. Lay down, my dear brother, lay down and take your rest. I wanna lay your head upon your Savior's breast. I love you, but Jesus loved you best. I bid you good night, good night, good night. I bid you good night. One of these morning, bright and early and soon, good night. Now they're picking up the spirit to the shore beyond, good night. We're walking in the valley of the shadow of death, good night. His rod and his staff gonna comfort me, good night. John the wise said I saw a sign, good night. Logs in a fire, not a flood next time, good night. Tell me, Father, all that wonderful boat, good night. She really loaded down, getting water to flow, good night. I'll be for the beast at the beginning of the world, good night. When walking to Jerusalem, just like John, good night, good night, oh, good night. Lay down, my dear brother, lay down and take your breath. I wanna lay your head upon your Savior's breast. Jesus loves you best. I bid you good night, good night, good night. I bid you good night, good night, good night. Oh, good night. Oh,
oh. I'm sure, and I know.